Hey, what up? Those that know me, you guys know what kind of stories I post. And I'm telling you, as I'm doing my research and getting ready to upload a video, I'm not gonna lie. I run across a lot of stories that would make great content. I probably get a lot of views and all this stuff, but I try to steer away from them because they involve kids. And I'm 100% against any kind of violence towards kids, even teenagers. You know, I don't understand, man. I don't get it. These are kids. Street politics and snitching and loyalty and all stuff, I get it, but I'm an adult. Shit, even some adults that should know better, they still don't get it. But these kids, holding them accountable and taking their lives over something they might have fucked up on, instead of teaching them or showing them what's up, like, really? Did we forget when we were kids? We weren't perfect. Us as kids, I'm pretty sure we fucked up. We fucked up, and we got taught a lesson, and we learned. But we didn't get our lives taken away. I mean, I don't care who you are. I don't care what your status is. We all, every single one of us, we all were kids at one point that did dumb shit. Youngsters, they don't know what's up. They may talk a big talk. They may talk a lot of shit. They may act like they know everything, but they don't. Even the kids that grew up in the hood, man, they don't know what's up. They don't fully comprehend. You know, they think everything's easy. They talk a lot of shit, but they're kids. They're learning. They're barely learning. But we're taking their lives? Yeah, and I know many of you are going to be like, well, they shouldn't get themselves caught up in adult stuff or involve themselves in that lifestyle. And they should know better. That's the consequence. And that's what they get. Okay, yeah. Okay, I get it. But those who are adults, we know better. They're kids. Again, they're kids. And yeah, I know kids are taking out kids. But that's because they're looking at us, the adults. They're imitating us. They're thinking that they're going to get some kind of status because us adults are leading them to believe that that's what they got to do. Is that what our elders told us to do? I'm sorry, but what I remember, my elder, they said, you got beef, you handle it. Not go and take somebody's life. You handle it. That gives you true status. You know? I mean, I don't know, man. The only reason I'm going to post this story is because it sounds like the mom needs help. And I'll tell you, no family should be going through what this family is going through. And I send mine from my family to them. My condolences. And if you're able to help out, please reach out and help this family.
New details this afternoon on the person who was found shot to death along the road in Canyon Country on Monday. We now know, according to the LA County Sheriff's Department, that the victim was just 12 years old. He's been identified as Willians Lemus Ayala. Ayala's body was discovered just after 6:30 Monday near the intersection of Sand Canyon and Placerita Canyon Roads. Officials have not released any information on the suspect at this time.
And now to a mysterious death investigation in Canyon Country, where a 12-year-old boy was found shot on the side of the road. A family is devastated as investigators search for answers. Detectives are trying to determine if this shooting is gang-related.
KTLA 5's Corrine Winter joining us now live from Canyon Country with more on this developing story. Corrine?
While detectives, they still don't have a motive in this case, and we spoke to some of the victim's friends earlier today, and they still have no idea why he was targeted. a remote, brush-filled spot along a dusty roadside here in Canyon Country. This is where investigators found the lifeless body of a 12-year-old boy, Willian Lemus Ayala. But how and why he ended up there is still a mystery.
Right now, you know, all the family is devastated. His mom is so devastated. It's so sad for them.
LA County Sheriff's officials say it's still unclear if Ayala was killed here at the intersection of Sand Canyon and Placerita Canyon Road, or if someone dumped his body here. He was shot to death in a case that may be gang-related. Authorities have not ruled out that possibility.
He was smart, respectful. He was a quiet guy.
Ayala, according to family friends, was a seventh grader at La Mesa Junior High, and they say while he didn't have many friends, he was fiercely protective of his family. His loved ones telling KTLA they wouldn't comment on their loss out of concerns of jeopardizing the ongoing case. But their focus now, laying Ayala to rest with a proper burial, hoping investigators will soon track down his killer.
And anyone with information in this case is being asked to contact the LA County Sheriff's Department. That's the latest here in Canyon Country. Corrine Winter, KTLA 5 News.
Thank you, Corrine.
12 years old. 12 years old. He was just a baby. And then just left on the side of the road like that. We gotta do better.